The XLOOKUP function in Excel is also great for looking up a specific value in a column and returning the whole row, much like the VLOOKUP. The VLOOKUP is better at returning a specific column, such as, you know, looking up this number and returning this amount, or this invoice number and returning this amount, where XLOOKUP will look up this invoice number and return this whole row. So it's great at filtering your data just for what you want to specifically see. We'll also need a lookup value that we plug into the function. So if we type equal XLOOKUP, the lookup value will be what we put under here. So we'll look up an invoice. So since we want to look up an invoice, we'll highlight this as the lookup array. And the return array will be this whole table, because we'll want to return the whole row. You could also specifically choose just this amount to return the date and due date, but we want the whole row. So we'll highlight that. And you don't have to worry about if not found or match mode or search for this, because we will want it to match. So we could type in 1005, add another zero, and it comes back with this. And so say we do a 7 instead, it will return this whole amount. We do need to format these to dates, and also we can format this. And once we do that, you can see that it matches exactly the data that's in the table. What choose allows you to do is pick from a list that will auto-populate into a cell based on the option that you choose. So let's say that this was option 1. This will populate in the price. So let's start with deleting this, going to price, type equal choose. So from equal choose, the index number will be this option number right here. And so for 1, the first value, or option number 1, or index 1, will be this. Then we just want to put a comma in between each one and just go down the list. And we're also going to want to hit F4 here to make this a fixed cell, so this will not move when we drag it over to units sold. So as you can see, nothing populates in here, but when we hit 1, you can see that this price populates to 50. If we put 2, 75. So now let's put 0, it won't populate. Let's drag this over. So now option 1 will pull the $50 price point and the amount of units sold here. We can change this to a general format. And then if we put option 2, it will pull the next. And option 3, we can see that the price point of 100 and 550 units that get pulled in will be the highest amount of revenue we can make. Based on this cell value, whether it's accounting, IT, it'll bring back who's in that department, or the whole entire row of this table. So the way we're going to want to use filter, we can start by deleting this and type equal filter. The array will be the whole table, followed by a comma, and include will be what we want to include. So we're looking this up by department, but you could also look it up by name or manager. So we'll highlight the whole column of department and set it equal to this cell here. So dependent on what this cell is, it will bring back the whole row of the table. And you don't have to worry about if empty. Hit equal. And so how we get a drop down here will be by going to the data tab, data validation, and we will clear all. But we will want to make a list. And so the source of this list will be the department right here. So whatever this column is minus the header, then you can click OK. And this will make a drop down list. So you can easily choose the departments that are available in this table, and it will come back with the full row of everyone who's in that department.